John had to paint ports and things like that. He told me he didn't enjoy it at all as much as the First World War, as it were. But he did some wonderful, rather architectural, very Revilius-like paintings. And he was a major in the Marines, but an official war artist. And Christine served, what the women's thing was. It was, to help the troops and the meals. I think they rather liked the wars, really, the second one. Yes. And then, in the middle of the war, they understood about this abandoned house and they bought it from a local farmer. And then Christine used to cycle here from Colchester to start sleeping in the granary to make it habitable. And then John and his friend made the garden or began to cut it out, sort of thing. And then very soon after, I came here as a youngster, having been befriended in a way by all these painters. And it had oil lamps and candles. I loved staying with them. The whole house smelled, as houses used to smell at that time, of paraffin oil and things. And I wrote here when they went away to paint. And then I, through Christine's friend, one way or another, went to Aldborough. And met Benjamin Britten and did this work for the Aldborough Festival and wrote short stories. And then after a couple of years there, I began to groan and moan about things. And Lady Cranbrook said, there's some cottages at Great Glemham near here, near there. You can have one of those. And there I began to be a writer, really. Mm-hmm.